Hello everyone, good morning. This is Nitin Pandey. First of all, I would like to thank Dr. Ranjit Kumar sir for inviting me to this amazing 11th e-conference on cybersecurity. And I would also like to thank IASR and SIPS. So today I'm going to talk about, cyber threats which are happening and how intelligence and law enforcement is tackling these things, like what are the trends, tactics and investigation things. So we are going to talk about these things. So let's begin. So first of all, let's understand what is cybersecurity mind map. So as we all know that cybersecurity is very, very vast. It's like an ocean. It's a very big domain. So, इसको कभी इसकी गहराई को हम नाप नहीं सकते और हम कभी खुद को ये नहीं कह सकते कि we are always a learner, because every day we see new things in this domain. So always we try to learn, because new kind of threats and challenges come every day. Because what I personally believe is the cyber criminals, they are very innovative. So that's why they find out new types of tactics to do cyber crimes and all. So this is cybersecurity mind map. As you can see here, threat intel, physical security, law enforcement, educational training, awareness. So it's very, very big. So talking about the era of internet users, if you talk about the old internet, as you can see on the left side, in 1980s, when the internet was very limited. So as you can see in the graph, the very less amount of internet users across the globe. And if you see the new internet, so you can see how much it has increased the use of internet. So this is a cyber threat evolution, we can say. So if you talk about how it began, and so from basic things, if you talk about virus and hacking websites, so it started like 1977, and then malware, malicious codes came by 2004, then advanced worm and Trojan, then identity theft, phishing, these things came in public. After that, DOS, DDoS attacks, attackers and cyber criminals, they started doing DOS, DDoS attacks to corporate world companies, to get ransom. So it was it's still a good tactic, you can say. They use to blackmail a company or someone. So now we are moving towards cyber warfare, what I personally believe. So talking about cyber threat intelligence, first of all, we need to understand what is threat, what is cyber threat. So we all know, any kind of cyber security, any kind of criminal activity or crime which is happening, the tactic, the technique, the modus operandi is being used in the crime. So first of all, we need to identify the threat, and then we use the intelligence. So if we define, so it is defined as a collection and analysis of information about the threats and drawing patterns, that provides an ability to make knowledgeable decisions for the preparedness, preventions, and response actions against various cyber attacks. So our focus is always on the threats. So this is another buzz. So anything likely to cause damage or danger is called threat. The ability to acquire and apply knowledge and skills equals by mixing both of these things, we can say that this is threat intelligence. So here, as you can see, some objects to analyze, like CTI lookup portal, and how there are so many open source tools, platforms are available to do lots of research and to gather as much as information we can get from internet, from open source. So talking about data, I'll talk about these things later on. Talking about data is, you can say, it is new gold. It is new gold for every company, for everyone, because all the companies we are using, for example, Facebook, or we can say Google. What they are doing, they are, there is a jung chal rahi hai, bol sakte hain, ek ladai chal rahi hai is samay duniya mein, kiske paas kitna data hai. So it is, you can call it information warfare. And the concern is our privacy, because we are living in a virtual world, especially in this COVID-19 pandemic. We are too much dependent on internet, these things. So and our each and every activity is being monitored by the apps we use. So always think twice before sharing something publicly and is installing any app, because sometimes what happens, दूसरों को देख के हम बहुत ज्यादा उत्तेजित हो जाते हैं और हम बिना सोचे समझे कोई भी चीज, फॉर एग्जाम्पल हैशटैग ट्रेंड्स, हैशटैग ट्रेंड्स इन रियलिटी यू आर समहाउ गिविंग द क्रिमिनल्स द स्कैमर्स अ वेरी इजी वे टू गेट योर पर्सनल थिंग्स. लाइक अभी एक हैशटैग चैलेंज चला था कुछ साल पहले, उसका नाम था हैशटैग कपल चैलेंज. बहुत सारे कपल्स उसमें बिना सोचे समझे, उनको पता भी नहीं था क्या है ये, और हैशटैग कपल चैलेंज में अपनी फोटो अपनी और अपनी वाइफ या गर्लफ्रेंड या लड़की अपने बॉयफ्रेंड हस्बैंड के साथ पिक्चर क्लिक करके, सेल्फी क्लिक करके ये लोग अपलोड कर देते थे. तो इसमें सो मेनी क्रिमिनल एक्टिविटीज हैपन जस्ट बिकॉज ऑफ दैट हैशटैग ट्रेंड. Even state police, they asked citizens not to participate in such kind of trends, hashtag trends. So like I was talking about, our each and every activity is being monitored by companies. So here's a good perfect example, you can say. This is in the picture, you can see the non-core permissions which applications take from us. If you will ever see notice, you will see that applications take some, most of the applications take unnecessary permissions from us. The permissions they don't actually need, but they still take it from us. So we don't know what they are going to do. Like for example, here you can see Hotstar. Hotstar is an entertainment app, but according to Google Play Store data, it also, I don't know about now, but at that time, when I had checked it, that time they were taking body sensors permission. Now just imagine, Hotstar, it's an entertainment app where you can watch videos, you can watch TV shows, movies, etc. And this app is taking body sensor permission, which is, you know, sounds very suspicious, because it's not a you can say it's not a fitness brand or fitness, like I have paired you know, the fitness watch. So if my fitness watch, the application takes body sensor permission, it's okay, because it needs, you know, to get my how you know my data, like how much kitna main chala hu, kitna main soya hu, ye sari cheeze janne ke liye. But agar ek entertainment app aise permission humse leti hai, to ye kafi concerning hai. So talking about, you know, active users, because of the pandemic, you know, users have increased somehow. People have started using Facebook not that much. पहले जितना करते थे, फेसबुक बहुत कम हो गया है. लोग फेसबुक से काफी हद तक इंस्टाग्राम और ट्विटर पे स्विच कर गए हैं. प्रोफेशनल्स आर यूजिंग लिंक्डइन. व्हाट्सएप इज स्टिल बीइंग यूज्ड आफ्टर यू नो द न्यू रूल्स एंड ऑल. सो दीज आर सम यू कैन से मेन प्लेटफॉर्म्स. देयर इज वन प्लेटफॉर्म मिसिंग व्हिच इज आल्सो very popular, and also criminals use it. It's Telegram. So this is, you know, the internet in India by 2020, by last year. So if you notice that by 2020 there were around 730 million 73 crore internet users the, and the most if you notice, the most important thing is new users were from, you know, rural areas. Gramin ilako se 75% se jyada users the 2020 because now everyone is using internet, because it's very cheap, it's, you know, affordable. So anyone can buy a sim, and they get deals, offers. Like a company had given, you know, free internet for, I think, for a year. So that's why everyone is using in the internet. So, you know, the massive increase in cybercrime had been seen in this COVID-19 pandemic. Around 3,000 domains had been registered with the keywords such as COVID, Corona, Covaxin, Pfizer, vaccine, Covin, etc. Still, there are so many, you know, fake applications, websites you will see. Recently, we had discovered one, AstraZeneca. There is a website known as AstraZeneca.in. in India. So what scammers did, they created a fake website on the same name, AstraZeneca, just with another extension. It was AstraZeneca.vip, and they were, you know, they had cloned the whole website, and they were just making people fool. So as you can see in the graph, 3.17 lakh cyber crimes in India in just 18 months is a government. So especially if you talk about women and children, they are, you know, at high risk. So what's the reason? So if you talk about the reason, you know, first reason is obviously lack of awareness. So awareness is the only key, I would say. So first of all, I would like to, you know, appreciate Dr. Ranjit Singh sir for, you know, continuously conducting such kind of events. I think this is this is 11th event in this year, and such events are, you know, required so that people get they understand what kind of criminal activities are being happened, what are new threats. So somehow lack of awareness is the main, you can say, a reason, because, you know, mostly victims, they don't know about threats, about scams. So, and most most victims, you know, they never report. And the second is loopholes in law enforcement. Somehow, you know, I would say that law enforcement agencies, especially in rural areas, they are, you know, a little bit outdated, untrained. They don't have, you know, the tools and all to solve, you know, to track a cybercrime related case. So there is, you know, the need is to, you know, to upgrade the law enforcement agencies, especially if you talk about the rural areas. And many believe that, you know, the law enforcement or intelligence, they are sleeping, but that's not the truth. They are not sleeping. Every day you read on, you know, news that this agency or this state police arrested these people for this. So they are doing their job. But if you talk about because India bhi bhi hum Bharat ek hum sab jante hain aur bolte bhi hain ki Bharat ek matlab abhi bhi hamara desh wo rural hai, matlab gramin hai, zyadatar log abhi bhi rural areas mein rehte hain. So isliye, you know, the rural areas law enforcement need to be trained, upgraded. So cyber related some most common threats. The most common is, you know, financial frauds, which happens, I think, every time. Right now, we are here at 11th International League Conference. So many financial scams have been happened. So apart from this internet, social media related crimes happening every minute, data breaches, like I was talking about data, you know, user data is new gold for a company, but these companies are so irresponsible that they are, you know, incapable of securing our data. And that's why, you know, we are getting scammed every day, because scammers are getting our details from these data breaches or leaks, you can say, ransomwares, phishing, surveillance. So these are some, you know, all these are some trending threats. And crypto, this time crypto, you know, everyone, not everyone, I mean, so many, especially youth, our youth, they are investing in cryptocurrencies, MLM, multi-level marketing. We had recently exposed a fake MLM company. जो लोगों को मतलब लोग पैसे इन्वेस्ट करा के बाद में वो उनको बेवकूफ बना के भाग जाती थी. तो देयर आर सो मेनी, यू नो, सिमिलर एमएलएम कंपनीज, अदर स्कैम्स, एंड डार्क वेब इज ऑल, यू नो, इट्स ऑलवेज इन ट्रेंड इफ यू टॉक अबाउट थ्रेड्स. सो बिकॉज यू नो सो मेनी इलीगल थिंग्स हैपन ऑन डार्क वेब because of the technology. So as I was talking about data breaches, so these are some biggest data breaches in India in 2021. So Domino's India was the biggest, it was most shocking data breach, which the size of, you know, 18 crore orders. They had the details. So MobiQuick, when it was getting circulated, I remember on Telegram, criminals, they had created so many channels on Telegram, KYC details and everything, your Aadhaar card, your PAN card, your details, ye sab matlab public aa gayi thi, publicly available thi. So just imagine, for a scammer, it is very easy, you know, to call you, and if they get your information, like your name, your father's name, your address, your PAN number, your Aadhaar numbers, so it is very easy for them to call you by, you know, impersonating themselves that they are calling from this bank and you need to do this KYC or anything. So if they have, you know, lots of information about about you, about me. So maybe sometimes we believe that if they know about even our PAN number, our Aadhaar number, our address, our date of birth, father's name, so maybe the person is authentic. And that's the reason, you know, people are becoming a victim. Facebook, Air India, recently GoDaddy, you know, it was very shocking. So when Domino's India data breach happened, so what they did, they created a search engine on dark web, and where you just need to enter a phone number or email ID and you will get these details easily, where your mobile number, your email ID, total number of, as you can see, total number of orders, everything, and your address, the most important thing, your address along with your latitude and longitude, ye sari cheeze publicly aa gayi thi. So just imagine if you know a stalker or a dangerous guy, or especially in school, in colleges, there are so many, you know, people, there are so many students, you know, they matlab ladkiyon ko wo matlab jaise ki, for example, they proposed a girl and she denied, so take revenge. If they get these details, maybe wo agle din unke darwaje pe khade rahe. So it is very concerning. Government need to, you know, make, I always say, I'm talking about personal data protection bill, I think since 2017, it's still pending in parliament. I think it's time for government to, you know, to implement the bill in parliament. So it is very important. I think in this winter session, they will implement, I hope so. You know, banning VPN is not that much important. So I will again say that, you know, implementing Personal Data Protection Act is very important now. So because, you know, these are the circumstances which could happen with a victim or anyone, you know, a person with a criminal mindset, especially, like I said, a stalker, it can, you know, access this data and collect the address of the target. And if someone has your number, they can look up the database and find your address. They might have show up on your doorstep or follow you. Hitmen, you know, they can buy this data and keep it in their database. So there are endless opportunities for the criminals. So after the leak, what is happened? This is my personal experience. A person from my, you know, you can say a relative of mine. He started, you know, getting these international calls and these SMSs after, you know, the Domino's data breach. So it is very concerning. So talking about, you know, trends, techniques, because I don't have much time, trends, techniques and tactics. So these are, you know, the incident, the, you can say, the most common incident reported in top states. So the states which are not mentioned here doesn't mean they are not you know, in top list. So because I cannot write name of all the states, just say example like Uttar Pradesh, Maharashtra, Delhi, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Gujarat, Kerala. So they are so trending themes, like I said earlier, hashtag challenges, like couple challenge, it's very risky. Pink WhatsApp, you know, pink WhatsApp aaya tha, it was, you know, a cloned version of WhatsApp. But it was in reality, it was a malware. So logon ko laga ki are wah isme kuch naya milega, kuch naye features milenge, WhatsApp pink ho jayega. Khas taur pe agar hum baat kare ladkiyon ko pink color pasand hota hai, to criminals kahin na kahin ye sab cheeze soch ke karte hain. To pink ek इस वजह से ये इसका नाम पिंक रखा गया, इसका जो आइकॉन बनाया गया पिंक बनाया गया, कि ताकि जो है लड़कियां खास तौर पे इसको इंस्टॉल करें, और वो एक मेलवेयर था, डेंजरस मेलवेयर था, कोविड लॉजिस्टिक्स यूरो, हवाला मनी लॉन्ड्रिंग, फेक न्यूज, व्हाट्सएप यूनिवर्सिटी इज यू नो हब ऑफ फेक न्यूज, ब्लैकमेलिंग केसेस, वीडियो कॉल्स एंड सेक्सटॉर्शन, यू नो दीज डेज पीपल आर रिसीविंग अननोन कॉल्स ऑन व्हाट्सएप और एनीवेयर वेयर वीडियो कॉल इज यू नो अवेलेबल लाइक इंस्टाग्राम. सो दे सी अ गर्ल हु इज कंप्लीटली नेकेड एंड शी इज डूइंग यू नो सम मतलब अश्लील हरकतें वो कर रही है. कई बार उसमें विक्टिम्स उस ट्रैप में फंस के वो भी अश्लील हरकतें करते हैं. दे रिकॉर्ड होल वीडियो एंड आफ्टर दैट दे स्टार्ट ब्लैकमेलिंग. सो इट इज हैपनिंग यू नो आई थिंक 15-20 केसेस तो जब ये अपने पीक पे था मुझे ही डेली 15-20 लोगों के मैसेज आते थे कि मेरे साथ ऐसा हो गया. सो डीप फेक फोटो मॉर्फिंग इट्स स्टिल यू नो बेस्ट टैक्टिक ऑफ क्रिमिनल्स टू ब्लैकमेल स्पेशली गर्ल्स. सोशल मीडिया टैक्टिक्स जमतारा यू नो वी ऑल अबाउट नो अबाउट द साइबर क्राइम हब. सो जमतारा महिपालपुर एंड मेवात these are your most more than 50% of cyber crimes are being operated from these towns. ek tagda idhar agar ek operation kar diya jaye I think to bahut sare crime saaf ho jayenge. jaise kerala mein abhi kuch samay pehle hua tha, kerala police ne kiya tha which was led by adg abraham sir. so it was a very you know it was really a great job by kerala police. So something like that needs to be done in Jamtara, Mahipalpur and Mewat. Is pe ek web series bhi ban chuki hai Jamtara pe. So COVID-19 pandemic, you know, smartphone dependencies, gaming addictions, we have seen so many kids, they killed their own father, their own family members, just an addiction of PUBG and all. Now PUBG is again back to India with a new name. E-commerce discounts on the name of discounts, they are making, you know, you a victim of a financial crime, lending loan frauds, malwares, you know, malicious applications or software, spywares, like I said, pink WhatsApp. So these what these are doing now, they don't need your OTP. ab OTP ka zamana gaya ki wo phone karke aapse aap OTP puchenge aur fir aapke account se paise. Now they are you know simply sending you an application which you are installing your phone and you are giving them remote access. After once they get the remote access, they get everything. They will get you know access of your SMS as well. So log jaake police station mein shikayat karte hain, sir maine to kuch diya hi nahi tab bhi mere account se itne paise chale gaye. Banking trojans, you know, the most common is any desk. Jitne bhi financial crimes hote hain, आप देखेंगे ज्यादातर में एनी डेस्क सॉफ्टवेयर ही इस स्कैमर क्रिमिनल्स यूज कहते हैं आपसे या विक्टिम से डाउनलोड करने को, और वो इजली कन्विंस होके कर भी लेते हैं. तो एक्सटॉर्शन लाइक रैंसमवेयर, डीडॉस, जीरो डेज, यू नो डेटा ब्रीचेस, लीक्स एज आई टोल्ड अर्लियर. सो MLM स्कीम्स, यू नो MLM Ponzi schemes, money doubling. Your money doubling is trending these days. कहते हैं आपके पैसा 24 घंटे में डबल कर देंगे लोग. अच्छा, लोग आसानी से इसमें इस ट्रैप में फंस भी रहे हैं. 10-10, 20-20 हजार, 50-50 हजार, 1-1, 2-2 लाख रुपया लोग लगा देते हैं जस्ट यू नो पैसे को दुगना करने की लालच में, और उनके पैसे डूब जा रहे हैं. गिव अवे स्कैम्स, यू नो क्रिप्टो करेंसी कनेक्शंस विद हैकर्स एंड टेररिज्म. It's not new, it's very old concept. we all know about the cryptocurrency connection with the hackers and terrorist organizations. That's why, you know, government of India is also concerned about cryptocurrency. They are going to regulate it. So the, you know, challenging and emerge, you can say, online cyber threats, understanding the modus operandi. So these are some, you know, common threats which are happening, like cyber bullying or harassment, which is very common. People do it, I think, every day. You will see that a girl receive vulgar messages from someone she doesn't know, or maybe she knows, but he or she is sending her, you know, abusive or vulgar things. Here you can see Bangalore Instagram friend blackmails minor girl to get her nude photos. These are very, you know, very common and pathetic things these criminals do. And this is very, really very common. ये बहुत ही मतलब सामान्य बात हो गई है कि ऐसी हरकतें करना, क्योंकि फोटोमॉर्फिंग डीप फेक टेक्नोलॉजी को यूज करके लोग ऐसी फेक फोटोज जनरेट क्रिएट भी कर देते हैं, जिससे वो आसानी से किसी भी लड़की को ब्लैकमेल कर देते हैं और वो मजबूर कई बार हो जाती हैं कि अपनी अपनी फोटोज में, कई बार लड़कियां सुसाइडल तक हो जाती हैं. सो दीज आर वेरी, यू नो, सीरियस एंड वेरी सीरियस क्रिमिनल ऑफेंस. So as you can see, youth held for harassing a girl online. So ये भी बेंगलुरु की न्यूज है, वहां पे पुलिस ने सबक सिखा दिया. तो morphing, as I was talking about morphing, they morph the picture. As you can see the in the picture one, there is a person, just notice his hair and the goggle. And second picture is of Mr. Bean. तीसरी पिक्चर में दोनों को मर्ज करके मिस्टर बीन को वही चश्मा लगा लग गया उनके चेहरे पे, और उनके उनका हेयर स्टाइल भी फर्स्ट जो पर्सन है फर्स्ट इमेज में उसका हो गया. तो दिस इज हाउ फोटोमॉर्फिंग वर्क्स. सो दिस इज, यू नो, दिस इज एन एग्जांपल ऑफ फोटोमॉर्फिंग. So that's how, you know, they morph pictures and they blackmail especially women. Deepfake technology, we are know, you know, about deepfakes. These are artificial intelligence generated media in which a person in an existing image or video is replaced with someone else likeness, while the act of faking content is not new. So as you can see the original and the deep fake, so you know, aap bata nahi sakte aasani se ki ye asli hai ya ye nakli hai, isko edit kiya gaya hai. So it's very difficult. Ye Barack Obama ki video bahut aap dekhenge YouTube pe, aapko easily mil jayegi kaise deep fake technology ki help leke hum, jaise main जो बोल रहा हूँ, मेरे वर्ड्स को चेंज किया जा सकता है. अभी मैं बात कर रहा हूँ यहाँ पे साइबर सिक्योरिटी, साइबर क्राइम, साइबर थ्रेट, इन चीजों की, हो सकता है इसको चेंज करके मेरे मुंह से गालियां निकाल दीजिए और सुनने वाले को लगे भी कि मैं गालियां दे रहा हूँ यहाँ पे बैठ के. As you see, you just saw how, you know, they are changing things with the using deepfake technology. Cyber stalking is very common everywhere. You know, the stalkers are everywhere. That's why I always say on social media that, especially to girls, that keep your account private. Don't share much information on social media. So cyber extortion is also, you know, it's very, very common threat in not just India, across the globe. Here you can see two youth from Bengaluru arrested in blackmail and extortion case. So CCB police Mangaluru ne inko arrest kiya, ye blackmail kar rahe the aur paise ki demand kar rahe the. Impersonation, when someone pretends to be another person, if you are pretending to be a twin brother all day at college, that's impersonation. So you can see youth held for impersonating a CBI officer. It is very common. CBI officer, बहुत आप देखेंगे इसमें जो ये नग्न वीडियो कॉल्स आ रही, इसमें जो है बाद में जब आपको ब्लैकमेल किया जाता है तो जब आपको कॉल आती है तो वो व्यक्ति आप खुद को बताता है कि मैं साइबर क्राइम ऑफिसर हूँ, मैं यूट्यूब ऑफिसर हूँ, मैं यूट्यूब केयर से बात कर रहा हूँ. आई विल शो यू एग्जांपल, रियल एग्जांपल विच आई हैड यू नो गेट आई हैड सॉल्व अर्लियर. सो दीज आर यू नो इलीगल कंटेंट्स, डार्क वेब, लाइक यू नो ड्रग्स, zero days, these are very common, pedo films and all, as you can see. So as I said, government is not law enforcement or intelligence agencies, they are not sleeping. If someone is thinking that I am using you know dark web, I'm using Tor, I'm using onion routing technique, so I'm 100% you know safe and anonymous. So anonymity is just an illusion. If agar aapko ek achhi aur ek tagdi law enforcement agency mil gayi, aap uske hath pe chadh gaye, matlab main aapki baat nahi kar raha hu, ek criminal ki baat kar raha hu, to us criminal ko pakadna unke liye bahut badi baat nahi hai. So you can see here then 10 arrested in Bengaluru for importing drugs using dark net. You can see Karnataka CCB arrest hacker in international drug case. Sextortion, it is also very you know common. Hashtag challenges, as I was talking about. Here you can see couple challenge. Oh, you know a cyber criminal, he doesn't need to you know Google pictures of usko Google karne ki zarurat nahi hai couples ki pictures. Usko simply यहाँ पे जाना है, कोई भी प्लेटफॉर्म खोलना है, फॉर एग्जांपल इंस्टाग्राम, लॉगिन करना पड़ेगा. सो लेट्स इग्नोर, इंस्टाग्राम पे गया, सर्च बॉक्स में उसने बस टाइप किया, सर्च बॉक्स में गया हाँ, और उसके बाद वहां पे उसने टाइप किया हैशटैग व्हाट इज दिस 82 ओटीपी या. तो वो बस हैशटैग सर्च किया कपल चैलेंज, सर्च करते ही लाखों करोड़ों पिक्चर्स अभी आप करो आपको दिख जाएंगी. सो you can imagine how you know easy for a criminal to get you know dozens of pictures from internet. So you can see couple challenge, challenge accepted, challenger, challenge yourself, 10 years challenge, 20 year, 50 year challenge. You can see here the pictures can be misused for revenge porn. Police Pune police on couple challenge, इसी की मैं बात कर रहा था. पुणे पुलिस ने जो है इससे बोला था और अर्ज किया था लोगों से कि प्लीज डू नॉट पार्टिसिपेट इन दीज थिंग्स, बिकॉज यू नो बहुत सारे केसेस वहां उस समय पुणे पुलिस को मिल रहे थे, कंप्लेंट्स मिल रही थी जहां पे रिवेंज पॉर्न और या फोटो मॉर्फिंग करके इन चीजों को मिसयूज किया जा रहा था. MLM स्कैम, यू नो रिसेंटली हमने एक्सपोज किया था, IX ग्लोबल करके एक कंपनी है, वी ऑल नो अबाउट यू नो क्यूनेट, व्हाट वाज हैपेंड विद क्यूनेट, एनआईए वाज लुकिंग इनटू यू नो फॉर द the funds which were transferred to Zakir Naik. So you know, sometimes big companies play a big role in terror fundings. So MLM is a perfect example for terror funding. Newly emerged, this I was talking about WhatsApp in pink. So आपको लगेगा कि न्यू फीचर्स मिल रहे हैं, लेकिन असली में आप जो है एक अपने आप को क्राइम की तरफ ढकेल रहे हो. So once you install your WhatsApp ping, your hacker will get your photos, your everything, your contact details, your net banking passwords. Maybe there's keylogger in the malicious application. Your SMSs, your OTP, and everything. You can see here in a major action, Delhi Police arrested that number of person for and they were running an online malicious. Here you can see Maharashtra Cyber. They had issued an advisory. Beware of malicious Android apps on Play Store. So it was about Joker malware. The modus operandi was Joker. We all know about Joker. So these were some applications which Maharashtra Cyber had issued. Agar ye application koi use kar raha hota, jaise for example photo editor, ye khas taur pe ladkiyan bahut use karti hain ye sab cheeze, photo editor, fancy keyboard, ye sab cheeze. To aap photo editor use kar rahe ho, fancy keyboard use kar rahe ho, लेकिन आपको नहीं पता कि मे बी वो कीबोर्ड असली में एक की लॉगर हो जो कि आपके सारे लॉक्स कलेक्ट कर रहा हो और वो किसी हैकर के पास सेंड कर रहा हो. फिशिंग वेरी कॉमन एंड स्टिल वी ऑल नो अबाउट सोशल इंजीनियरिंग टैक्टिक्स, हैकिंग ह्यूमन माइंड. सो इट इज स्टिल you can say one of the most sabse zyada safal technique hai ek cyber criminal apradhi ke liye, aaj bhi use ki jati hai aur kafi had tak wo safal bhi ho jate hain. So ye inko dekhiye, ye inhone to puri website hi bana dali thi, railway ki puri fake website hi. Just sochiye agar koi vyakti aisi harkatein karta hai aur वो 100 रुपया 200 रुपया रिक्रूटमेंट के नाम पे ले रहा है, और लोगों को कहीं ना कहीं एम्प्लॉयमेंट की तो कमी है ही हमारे देश में, तो लोग 100-200 रुपया दे के और अपना रजिस्ट्रेशन करने में वो 2 मिनट भी नहीं सोचेंगे. बिकॉज गेट अ गवर्नमेंट जॉब इज रियली अ चैलेंजिंग टास्क इन इंडिया, और कोरोना के टाइम से तो बहुत ज्यादा चैलेंजिंग हो गया. जॉब्स वगैरह जिनके थी उनकी चली गई है, तो नए लोगों को जॉब्स मिलना तो बहुत मुश्किल है, वो भी गवर्नमेंट. तो ऐसी हरकतें करते हैं. अब सोचिए अगर 100 रुपया भी ले रहा है एक स्कैमर, एक हैकर या इस टाइप का एक क्रिमिनल, तो अगर 1000 लोगों ने भी वहां पे रजिस्ट्रेशन कर लिया और 100-100 रुपए दे दिए, तो उसके पास अच्छा खासा अमाउंट हो गया. वीक पासवर्ड्स, दीज आर ऑल्सो सम रीजंस. मनी डबलिंग स्कैम्स, जैसे मैंने बताया आपको, दुगना का झांसा दे कंपनी ने ठगे 1.5 करोड़. सो ये देखिए, ये मुझे मैसेज आया था, तो वैसे मुझे बहुत सारे आते हैं. ये कुछ वो हैं कौन बनेगा करोड़पति के नाम पे आते रहते हैं सोशल मीडिया पे, 25 लाख के नाम. Your password will expire in one day. My university, your renewal. आपने जहाँ renewal पे क्लिक किया, maybe it's phishing page or any malicious page. COVID-19 scams. So here you can see unknown video calls and ransom demand. Woman blackmails man over his nude video. So if you talk about threat intelligence, to defend your data you need knowledge, that's threat intel. So trust is one of the most challenging attributes, we can say, of cyber that intelligence sharing. Traffic light protocol is defined in four colors in CTI, namely white, which means no restrictions, green, sharing with peers and partners, not publicly, amber, sharing only outside own organization on who need to know basic, and red means no sharing. So indicator of compromise in cybercrime: URL, domain, mobile number, SMS gateways, UPI handle, wallet, bank details, profile, anything it could be. This is the process cycle of threat intel, you know, planning and direction, collection and processing of data, and the analysis and production, distribution. So the threat intelligence life cycle is, you know, a continuous process of developing intelligence from the raw data that supports organizations to develop defensive mechanism. Talking about, you know, open source intelligence, the most आजकल इसका एक ट्रेंड चल गया, फैशन बन गया है. आप देखेंगे सब प्रोफाइल पे लिखा रहता है ओपन ओसेंट. तो दे यू नो पीपल डोंट नो द डिफरेंस इन बिटवीन ओपन सोर्स इंटेलिजेंस एंड ओपन सोर्स इंफॉर्मेशन. ओपन सोर्स इंफॉर्मेशन को भी ओपन सोर्स इंटेलिजेंस समझ के वो बोलते हैं कि आई एम डूइंग ओसेंट. So first of all, let's understand what actually OSINT is. So open source information, you know, information which is available on, you know, public domain, collected from open sources such as newspapers, blogs, posts, social media, etc. So this is, you know, open source. How intelligence is, you know, related with this term, I will show you. So this is, you can see open source intelligence framework. Here you can see, if I click on username, so you can see, so they have created a great framework, you know, open source framework. So username search engines, you can see here so many. So what's my name? For example, what's my name? So I'll show you. So similarly, email address, email search, you know, email verification, breach data. Clicking on breach data, have I been pwned? He has Intel X. So these things, you know, are something interesting. So let me show you how, you know, we can use intelligence map dot. बहुत सारे लोग स्नैपचैट यूज करते होंगे और एंटरटेनमेंट के लिए, पर बहुत लोगों को नहीं पता होगा कि देयर इज, यू नो, वेरी गुड फीचर इज अवेलेबल इन इन स्नैपचैट. तो यहाँ पे आप देख सकते हैं कि रेड और येलो और ब्लू कलर में हमें चीजें दिख रही हैं. इसका मतलब है जितना, जहाँ पे जितना डार्क है उतना ज्यादा वहां पे एक्टिविटीज हो रही हैं, जितना कम है वहां पे उतनी कम हो रही हैं. जैसे कि अभी सऊदी अरबिया में कुछ उधर हो रहा है. तो इफ वी टॉक अबाउट इंडिया, सो लेट्स सी हाउ, यू नो, हाउ वी कैन गैदर इंफॉर्मेशन डेटा फ्रॉम, यू नो, दीज एप्लीकेशंस अवेलेबल ऑनलाइन. So, अगर मान लीजिए कोई बड़ा मुद्दा चल रहा है, जैसे कि अभी CA को लेके बहुत समय से वो हो रहा था, किसान आंदोलन चल रहा था, सालों चला है, अभी भी शायद चल रहा है. तो अभी हैदराबाद में जो है इस समय, देखिए यहाँ पे ज्यादा दिखा रहा है रेड, विच मीन्स समथिंग, यू नो, interesting is happening here. अभी शायद इंडिया में कुछ नहीं, इंडिया में नहीं, साउथ अफ्रीका में कुछ कोई नया एक वेरिएंट पाया गया कोविड का, तो अगर वो हम उधर देखेंगे तो उधर भी हमें चीजें दिखेंगी। यू कैन सी हियर इन तेलंगाना समवन पोस्टेड इट एट 9:04 AM। दिस इज यू नो 14 मिनट्स अगो। सो इन चीजों से ये देखिए, सो दीज यू नो दीज थिंग्स हेल्प समटाइम्स टू लॉ एनफोर्समेंट, टू इंटेलिजेंस एजेंसीज, टूगेदर यू नो लॉट्स ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन can gather from these applications. So, जैसा कि आप देख सकते हैं, सो दिस इज यू नो हाउ इट वर्क्स एंड इट इज वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग। जब मुझे याद है किसान आंदोलन चल रहा था, उस समय हमें बहुत सारी दिल्ली में बॉर्डर्स, बहुत सारी हमें अच्छी अच्छी चीजें मिल रही थी, अच्छी मतलब कि इंफॉर्मेटिव, जो कि इंफॉर्मेशन हमारे काम आ सकती है। तो भोपाल so you can see you know there are so if you will click on anywhere Bharat Mata ki Jai, so they are doing some the bus terminal pe can gather you know thousands and thousands of इंफॉर्मेशन फ्रॉम दिस प्लेटफॉर्म, जिसके 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 बारे में आई थिंक बहुत कम ही लोग इन चीजों के बारे में जानते होंगे। नॉर्मल यूजर्स की मैं बात कर रहा हूँ, नॉट अबाउट सिक्योरिटी यूजर्स, आई मीन पीपल लखनऊ। जैसे लखनऊ को हम देख सकते हैं, तो कभी कई कई बार हमें ऐसी इंफॉर्मेशन मिल जाती है जो कि हमारे लिए बहुत काम आ जाती है। तो इट वाज एन एग्जांपल ऑफ इफ यू टॉक अबाउट यू नो लाइव, यू कैन सी हियर लाइव साइबर थ्रेट, दिस इज लाइव साइबर थ्रेट मैप। सो राइट नाउ हियर यू कैन सी 7,06,84,000 अटैक्स ऑन दिस डे। इतने अटैक्स हो चुके हैं, 7 करोड़ से ज्यादा अभी तक। और मोस्ट इंटरेस्टिंगली यहाँ पे आपको ये भी पता चल जाएगा किस टाइप के अटैक्स किए जा रहे हैं और कहाँ पे। एज यू कैन सी फ्रॉम यूनाइटेड स्टेट्स टू नीदरलैंड, इंडिया, इंडिया पे भी हो रहा, रशिया टू समवेयर हांगकॉन्ग, जापान, यूएस टू इंडिया, इंडिया पे जो है अटैक हो रहा है। तो किस टाइप के अटैक्स हो रहे हैं, क्या चीजें हैं, सो ऐसी बहुत सारी हमको जो है, लाइक यू कैन सी टॉप मेलवेयर टाइप्स, बॉट नेट, फिशिंग, बैक डोर्स, सो दीज आर द टॉप अटैक्स विच आर यू नो बीइंग यू नो दे आर डूइंग। टॉप टारगेटेड कंट्रीज यू कैन सी हियर, जॉर्जिया, नेपाल एंड सो ऑन। सो दिस मैप इज यू नो वेरी इंफॉर्मेटिव इन केस यू नो इफ वी नीड टू गैदर डेटा। सो दीज प्लेटफॉर्म्स आर वेरी यूजफुल टू कलेक्ट डेटा। सो इट्स अ वेरी गुड एग्जाम्पल ऑफ यू नो लाइव साइबर थ्रेट like you can say cyber wars are being, you know, happening around the globe. तो उसी की तरह जो है कुछ ऐसे टूल्स हैं जो कि ऑनलाइन अवेलेबल हैं, आप डाउनलोड कर सकते हो. फॉर एग्जांपल स्पाइडर फुट डॉट नेट है, जो कि यू नो बहुत ही अच्छा ओपन सोर्स इंटेलिजेंस टूल है. सो यू कैन सिंपली डाउनलोड इट फ्रॉम हियर, सर्च कोड. So let's try to search something. Let's try me. Like I everywhere I use I Nitin Pandey. Let's see if we get something. Nothing. So search engine for internet of everything. So this is dark search, the first real dark web search engine on, you know, surface web. So let's try to insert something. Our Tor address is here. So let's search something like daddy. Here you can see there are so many dark web results. So dark websites, we all know the extension is .onion. So you can see there are news about GoDaddy. So these are, you know, some tools which are very informative if we talk about gathering or collecting data or information about anyone. So, as you can see, when I typed searching my website nitinpandey.info, so you can see the who is record, the MX records. So जो मेरे accounts connected हैं, email accounts Zoho पे, वो सारी चीजें जितनी बहुत मैं मतलब ये बोलूंगा कि अपने आप में इंटेलेक्स जो है एक बहुत ही शानदार टूल है, और बहुत ही इसमें बहुत ही अच्छे फीचर्स हैं. फाइंड आउट व्हाट वेबसाइट्स आर बिल्ट इन. So you can search and gather, you know, lots of details from these platforms. Spice, this is also very informative tool. Spider food. what's my name. So if you search, like I was talking about, जैसे usernames होते हैं, mostly लोग अपने usernames same ही रखते हैं हर जगह. Like I use I Nitin Pandey everywhere. So if we search, so it is searching right now. So as you can see here, it is processing. So from this website, you know, what's my name.app, you can, you know, get so many details of mine. Like here, you can easily see on GitHub, my profile. My GitHub profile, Gravatar, Hacker One, Instagram, Pinterest, SlideShare, so Telegram, Twitter. So जितनी जगह मैंने ये use किया है username, वो सारा सारा का सारा आ गया. तो इसी तरह से बहुत सारी चीजें हम search कर सकते हैं, not just username, we can search, you know, and numbers of things. So citizen, this is, you know, very important, but it is mostly active in US, where you can see all you need to, you know, just search the area and you will see what's happening there. So these were some open source, some you can call some good platform from where you can gather information. So as I said, open source, Intel X. So if you talk about Intel X, if I enter my email ID, inithinpandey@gmail.com. So you can see the results, total number of leaks. 15 jagah jo hai, mera email ID leak ho chuka hai. So jahir si baat hai, itne jyada data breaches ho rahe hain, to ye bahut common hai ye sari cheeze. So abhi jaisa ki humne dekha, what's my name, how it works, have I been pwned? There is also a question that when we search, you know, information about ourselves, because, you know, they also now they have a feature of, you know, searching your password. So kahin aisa na ho ki aap apna password search kar rahe hain ki aapka password kahin kisi data breach mein hai ya nahi. Us chakkar mein aap already kisi ko apna password de rahe hain. Have I been pwned? He pwned ho jaye. So it's concerning, but yes, I would say that this is very helpful. So talking about, you know, search engine, reverse search engine. So investigation methodology, if you talk about it, that sorry, the role of, you know, role of criminal OSINT plus LEA, legal authorities, plus forensics. So in the picture you can see two ladies, and they were, you know, suspect in drugs. Here, if you upload this picture, and you will see the results. You know, bahut sare aise search engines hain, like Yandex, which, so, you know, some great information they collect and gather from, you know, internet. Aap jaise ki, as you can see here, in the search results, you know, the names of these sisters arrested in dark web bust. One of two sisters sentenced to 8 years of involvement in $17 million drug scandal. So दिस इज अ केस मेरे पास आया था अभी रिसेंटली. सो व्हाट हैपेंड, समवन यू नो इट वाज बेस्ड इन लखनऊ, लोकल केस इट वाज. सो द एंड द द victim's son is my known. So what happened, he's a retired bank manager from Lucknow. He received an unknown video call on WhatsApp, and he saw the girl who was completely nude, and he got trapped and did the mistake what they were trying him to do. Let me tell you that most of the times they use some plugins जिससे आपको लगता है कि वो, या आपको ऐसा लगेगा कि वो सच में हम किसी लड़की से बात कर रहे हैं, वो लड़की जो है सच में हमें कॉल की है, वो नंगी है, वो ये सब चीजें हमें दिखा रही कर रही है. कई बार वो ऐसे प्लगइन्स यूज करते हैं और वो वीडियोस जो है वो इंटरनेट से यानी पॉर्न वेबसाइट से डाउनलोड करके उसको प्ले कर देते हैं, और लोगों को लगता है कि वो लड़की असली है और वो आसानी से वो शिकार बन जाते हैं. सो यही सेम चीज यहाँ पे हुआ. देन ही रिसीव्ड अ वाइप कॉल ऑन व्हाट्सएप. पर्सन सेड दैट ही इज फ्रॉम क्राइम ब्रांच एंड ही सेंट हिम सेम वीडियो बिकॉज दे रिकॉर्ड द वीडियो. एंड देन ही आस्क्ड दैट immediately contact the YouTube officer to remove the video before it gets uploaded on YouTube. So when the victim called the fake YouTube officer, he asked 70,000 rupees to remove the video. So it was like the blackmailing started. So he got an anxiety attack, and he was hospitalized for 2 hours. So I still remember because ऐसी चीजों में लोग जो है वो बताते भी नहीं हैं किसी को कि ऐसी ऐसी चीजें हो गई और मुझसे भी थोड़ी गलतियां हो गई. सो बट जब वो अपने घर गए अपने बेटे के साथ, तो वो चेक लेके जो है अपनी बैंक विजिट करने जा रहे थे, तो उनका उनका बेटा उनसे पूछा होगा और उन्होंने फिर बताया होगा कि ऐसी ऐसी बात हुई. तो हिज सन उनके बेटे ने मुझे कॉल किया और बताया इनके बारे में बिफोर कि वो वहाँ पे चेक वगैरह सबमिट कर देते. उससे पहले ही अच्छा हुआ कि उनके लड़के ने जो है मुझे कांटेक्ट किया और बताया कि ऐसी ऐसी बात हुई है. तो हुआ ऐसा कि इस जो क्रिमिनल था उसने ये प्रोफाइल पिक्चर लगा रखी थी. अब इसमें जो है सबसे इंटरेस्टिंग पार्ट था कि ये प्रोफाइल पिक्चर अगर हम देखें इसमें एज वी कैन सी टू सीनियर आईपीएस ऑफिसर्स यू कैन इजली आइडेंटिफाई. सो अ क्राइम ब्रांच ऑफिसर, वो एक क्राइम ब्रांच ऑफिसर मतलब इस रैंक के ऑफिसर जो है ऐसे कॉल्स नहीं करेंगे. तो ये एक अपने आप में हम सस्पिशियस हो जाते हैं. So after searching, after reverse image search, I found that the profile picture, the DP he was using, the criminal was using, it was actually of Jammu and Kashmir DGP Dilbagh Singh sir. Dilbagh sir ki picture, profile picture wo use kar raha tha person jo ki khud ko crime branch ka officer bol raha tha. Aur जो यूट्यूब ऑफिसर था उसने एक फेक आईडी कार्ड भी भेजा था विक्टिम को. यू कैन सी हियर द आईडी कार्ड ही सेंट. नो, गूगल पे बहुत सारे गवर्नमेंट आईडी कार्ड्स अवेलेबल हैं, आप सर्च करोगे आपको मिल जाएंगे. तो ये करते क्या है, उसमें छोटा मोटा एडिट, जैसे एज यू कैन सी हियर यूट्यूब केयर डेली, तो यूट्यूब केयर डेली करके इन्होंने यहाँ पे एक एक, एक झूठा यूट्यूब केयर बना दिया. So that was the case, and here you can see in the complaint on National Cybercrime Reporting Portal, my husband got multiple number of video calls at midnight. He picked up calls out of curiosity. Nothing was visible in video call, So he kept on asking, who is it? Video isn't clear. The person took his video, edited it, clubbed it and some sexual stuff, and is now sending us video on WhatsApp and asking us money, or else he will upload the video on social media platforms like YouTube, Facebook and Instagram. So that was the complaint. So you can see how common these things are. So SMS, ransom demands, you know, digital footprints, talking about digital footprints. So every criminal should, you know, remember that digital footprints remain even after destroying everything. Data can be, you know, deleted data can be retrieved. So anonymity is just an illusion. So it is very, this is very famous in our cybersecurity domain. Me on my bed, bed. So my last wish delete my browser history, son. So why this is very popular is because if I get your phone just for 2 minutes, तो मैं आपके बारे में बहुत सारी चीजें जान जाऊंगा. मतलब आप किस टाइप के व्यक्ति हैं, आपको किन चीजों में रुचि है. बिकॉज यू नो योर सर्च इंजन्स tells a lot about it. So there was a very interesting case where Major Honda, he killed his fellow's wife Salja, and he googled how to destroy evidence. Google karne ki wajah se hi ye jo hai pakde gaye. So this is how, you know, मतलब हमारे व्हाट जो हम सर्च करते हैं, हमारा ब्राउजर हिस्ट्री, वो क्या क्या कर सकता है. क्रिप्टो करेंसी फ्रॉड्स, यू नो, दीज आर आल्सो एट पीक. सो यू कैन सी इंजीनियर लॉसेस रुपीज 17.85 लाख टू फेक स्टॉक ट्रेडर्स. सो रिपोर्टिंग साइबर crime, just promoting a national cybercrime reporting portal. So if someone becomes a victim of cybercrime, they can, you know, visit cybercrime.gov.in. there are three options available here: report women, child related crime, report anonymously. If you don't want to share your identity, there is option, you can keep your identity safe, you can report anonymously. And third one is a report other kind type of cyber crimes. So it is, you know, the best part is it is interconnected with each and every police station across the nation, like Maharashtra. You can see all the streets, Maharashtra, Uttar Pradesh, Haryana, Madhya Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, Rajasthan. So it is connected with every state, and this is how it works. Once you visit cybercrime.gov and you file your complaint, it goes to your nearest police station or cyber crime branch, and you receive a call from your, you get an acknowledgement number and details, and you could receive a, you know, phone call from your police station, and then they ask you to, you know, visit the station for written statement or for more to provide more information. So many times, especially girls, when they I receive messages from girls, they say that, sir, this happened with me. In most cases, I notice that they delete the evidences. कई बार शर्म में या वो मतलब इन चीजों को बताने नहीं चाहते कि उन फोटो मॉर्फी है, तो उन चीजों को वो डिलीट करते हो. सो यू नो, ऑलवेज कीप ऑल द स्क्रीनशॉट्स, मैसेजेस, कॉल रिकॉर्डिंग्स, एवरी काइंड ऑफ, यू नो, टाइप ऑफ एविडेंस सिक्योरली. एंड बिकॉज यू नो फॉर LEA, दीज एविडेंसेस आर वेरी इम्पोर्टेंट. सो नेवर डिलीट एन एविडेंस. दिस इज हाउ यू, एज यू कैन सी, ग्रेवियंस हैज बीन सक्सेसफुली रिपोर्टेड on cybercrime.gov.in with the acknowledgement number. then you can see the status got changed, and it got changed to accepted. And then you, in the third picture, you can see it, they forwarded it to Kotwali. So there is another great initiative of Ministry of Home Affairs for financial crimes. There is a helpline number 155260, where you can call if in case of any financial fraud, you can call and report immediately. So Ministry of Home Affairs started, you know, citizen financial cyber fraud and reporting and management system for prevention of money loss in case of cyber financial fraud. So for immediate reporting, just call 155260. It works 24/7 in some states, but not in. So right now it's currently available in these states like Delhi, Rajasthan, Uttarakhand, Chhattisgarh, Uttar Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh, Telangana, Maharashtra, Odisha, Arunachal Pradesh, Assam, Tamil Nadu, Kerala, Puducherry, Dadar Nagar, and Gujarat, Manipur. So victims of, you know, online cyber frauds should immediately report the matter on helpline number 155260 within 24 hours of the incident for, you know, timely action in respect of defrauded money. If incident is being reported after 24 hours, then victim need to file the complaint at cybercrime.gov.in. So here you can see, और ये बहुत सक्सेसफुल भी है, बहुत सारे, स्पेशली यू कैन सी द ट्वीट फ्रॉम डीसीपी साइबर क्राइम दिल्ली. इस हेल्पलाइन की मदद से, हेल्पलाइन नंबर की मदद से, आई मीन 155260 की मदद से अब तक 4,11,00,000, इट्स अ बिग अमाउंट, यू नो, 4,11,00,000 साइबर ठगों तक पहुंचने, रुपए साइबर ठगों से तक पहुंचने से रोक लिए गए हैं. तो यू नो दे सेव्ड मोर देन 4 crore rupees. सो देयर इज वन वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग थिंग फॉर यू नो दोज स्टूडेंट्स एंड लर्नर्स enthusiasts, they can, you know, if you want to, because I receive messages, I think most of us receive message like, I want to work with law enforcement, I want to help people, I want to help. This is very good thing, and I must say that I this is, you know, everyone should appreciate if someone wants to help victims, because sometimes, you know, they don't get good assistance, the victims. So there is very good initiative of Ministry of Home Affairs cyber volunteer, where you can, you know, you can just visit and register yourself, and then you can assist your state or UT law enforcement agencies for cyber hygiene promotions as technical experts, or for, you know, reporting of unlawful content. So that's all. I think I took lots of time, sorry for that. So thank you so much, and once again thank you so much, Dr. Ranjit Singh sir, for inviting me to speak about, you know, some shoes and things, share my views. So if you have any query, you can contact me on this number, or you can email me. So thank you so much, and Jai Hind.